Welcome back. In the last two videos, we were working on our spawning volume, and we wrote code to specify where to spawn, and then what to spawn, and actually set up that first spawning function. And now we're going to work on some code with timers to actually call that spawning function and define when to spawn. So we're back in our spawn volume. Actually, we're going to go to the header and start setting up some new variables. We're going to protect or create a timer handle. And we're going to make that protected so that only this class or our child classes can reset the timer and work with the timer, basically. We're going to call that spawn timer. And that actually doesn't get a uProperty macro applied because timer handles can't be uProperties. So also protected, we're going to make some values for like a minimum and a maximum spawn delay. So, like I said, minimum spawn delay, and max spawn delay. And those are both going to be floats. Spawn delay range low. And I'm just going to copy that and change low to high on the maximum. These are both going to be uProperties, so they can be set in the editor, they can be handled with all the garbage collection, all of that. So edit anywhere. Blueprint read write, so if we made a blueprint of the spawn volume at some point, we could change the spawn delay dynamically in blueprints. Say maybe you powered up and you wanted batteries to rain from the sky, or you wanted there to be some slow-mo and then they didn't fall quite as often. And then again, one of our old friends, the category keyword, and these will still be in the spawning category. And this is again very much the same for spawn delay range high, so we're just going to make those match. Edit anywhere, blueprint rewrite, and in the spawning category. And down here in the private section of the header, we're going to store the actual spawn delay, which was going to fall somewhere in that range. The reason we're making this private is we're only going to handle it on the code side. We don't want to be able to edit this in the blueprint because we want to set all the rules in code and not let them be changed by any child class. So the current think that that's everything we have to do here in the header. So we've got the, again, the timer handle, the low end of the range, the high end of the range, and then the actual delay. Now let's switch over to the source file and set some default values for our spawn delay range. So we're going to set the spawn delay range. And we'll say the low end at 1, and I'm just going to copy this down quickly. The high will say 4.5, and again, this is just because I've been tweaking the system. I'm sure, you know, we'll actually, I think, set some new values for this when we place them in the level, but, you know, every second to just short of every 5 seconds is enough, so you're not getting tons of pickups piling up, but it's not like you're really just sitting there waiting for one to pop in. Now, in begin play, we are going to set the first time that the timer is called. First, we need to get the time, so set a value for spawn delay. And that's just going to be using another function in fmath to get a random value and range for a float. That's frand range. And if you see here in the sort of autocorrect help, it takes a minimum and a maximum. So we're just going to put those in here. The low and then the high. If we had some formula that we wanted a more complex, you know, weighting towards either the low end or the high end, then we could definitely break this out into its own function. But we always just kind of want a random value within the range between the low and the high. Then we're going to use the world timer manager. And this just keeps track of all the timers that are going on throughout your project, throughout the game. And it's got a lot of built-in functionality, which you can see, you know, clearing timers, figuring out the time since how long a timer's been running, whether or not it's active. And if you want to learn more about this, we're using it in other series, and we want to do more explanations like this. So we're going to use set timer. And that timer handle we set up before was spawn timer. So you see it's taking a handle. Then this. We are going to bind it to the spawn volume spawn pickup function we set up before, so that gets called. The time that it until the timer fires will be spawn delay, and we put in false because it's not going to loop. So again, we take the handle for this class. We bind it to the function for spawn pickup. For spawning the pickup, we say fire after the spawn delay and don't loop. So this whole little block will get called when the game starts. We're also going to take this little block and put it at the end of our spawning function that we wrote in the last video, right here after the pickup is actually spawned. So it'll only get called again if our what to spawn is valid and if we've got a world. So let's just put that in there. That means after we spawn one pickup, we'll reset the timer to another random time between the low end of the range and the high end of the range. So we'll compile this, and actually we'll switch back to the editor to compile, because at this point we should have a fully functional spawn volume and we can actually test it out. So we'll compile here. Okay, so we finished compiling, and now we can create some instances of our spawn volume. If we wanted to, say, procedurally fill in these volumes or something, we could definitely make a blueprint and set these same properties on that, but because we're just laying out in this one level, we can drag them directly in, like so. So let's make one here. Make it just slightly larger. And for this one, we will set our base pickup to spawn. And let's make that a little slower. So maybe every two 6 seconds. And then we'll put another spawn volume. And make this one maybe a longer rectangle. And set the battery blueprint to spawn. And if you notice, the only things showing up here in this list are things that inherit from the base pickup class. And that's because we use that T subclass of template. So we only have pickup, the pickup blueprint, the battery pickup, and the battery blueprint. And let's make this one spawn more quickly, just so you can see what happens when we've got sort of faster spawn rate. And it's that easy just to sit and change the values. Let's go ahead and hit play. And at this point, you can see both the big pickup that doesn't, sort of the base that doesn't have any physics on, spawn in at different rotations. And then the batteries over here spawning much more quickly. So we were able to set two different types of pickups to our spawn volumes, try two different rates, and test them out in our level. Thanks.